Greetings people from Beer's Blend, my name is Ronald, and yes, well, welcome back to another video. It has been, what, a couple months since I last uploaded a video, and well, I'm not going into the whole detail again about everything, but yeah, I will still upload on this channel every once in a while. I think that because I'm on vacation at the moment, I will record a couple videos, etc., to post them, well, I don't know, in the upcoming months and weeks. Today, well, this is probably the main reason why I created a video again. because I almost finished. Dit is echt waardeloos. Greetings people from Beer's Blend, my name is Ronald and welcome back to the channel. I want to thank every single one of you who sticks around and watches my videos whenever the planets are in line. But yeah, when I will upload a video, I don't know. The main reason why I, well, wanted to create a video again is because I almost finished this bottle. And that's one thing I said to myself, I don't want to finish a bottle without making a review of it. I have a couple bottles that are about to, well, hit danger levels. So, yeah, I will probably just create a couple of reviews and post them, yeah, the coming weeks and months, etc. But yeah, just so you know, I am still active on here. I just don't upload a lot because I am super, super busy. And well, it seems that every single person these days is super, super busy. And well, it just is. Life's crazy. But yes, today we have Laphroaig Select. This is one that I picked up kind of on a rush because, well, it was on a discount at a local liquor store of mine. I paid, what, like 26 euros or something for it. I don't remember. But yeah, it was hella cheap and I thought, well, let's just give it a shot. I know Laphroaig Select is one of the Laphroaigs that's, well, known for its lack in quality, lack in excitement, blah, 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 blah. I don't think that's the case actually, but yeah, with every Laphroaig bottling you get a Laphroaig passport. You can claim your own free square foot of land on Isla with the Laphroaig distillery. So yeah, if you buy enough bottles you can get a house on Isla, but yeah, then you have to spend a fortune on whiskey. So yeah, but this is like what, the cheapest Laphroaig, and well, yeah, you can do the math about, well, how much square foot you would need for a house and then how much Laphroaig you need to buy to obtain that. But let's not get into that right now. Let's talk about the whiskey and, well, Laphroaig in, don't knock that over. Laphroaig in general, I already broke enough glass. Not gonna happen again. So yeah, Laphroaig is probably next to Ardbeg, one of the most, and Lagavulin of course, well-known distilleries on Isla. It's peaty, it's antiseptical, it's hospitally-like, smoky, you go on and on and on. And they have age statements. The 10 years old is probably one of the most known whiskies out there amongst, well, whiskey lovers, etc. And everybody loves it. This is, well, Laphroaig Select. It's a bit different here. There's a little story on the back of it I will read to you. This special Laphroaig is created from carefully selected casks of each of our key stylists, stretching back in time with one notable addition. The heart of the spirit is drawn from a final maturation in new American oak casks, rarely used for Scotch whiskey maturation. Not entirely true, but okay. Bottled at natural color, the result is an exquisite Laphroaig with our trademark peat reek, matched by an additional layer of complexity and depth brought about by the fusion of the maturation styles in different oaks. So yeah, we have yeah, it doesn't say on the bottle what type of, oh here, we have spirits selected from our master distillery from quarter cask, our PX cask and triple wood, especially European cask. It's represented by subtle blah 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 blah, bottled natural color blah 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 blah. It's that time of the season again. So yeah, Perrault, Chimenez, sherry and bourbon barrels basically. That's yeah, well, new American oak, so not really bourbon barrels, but yeah, you probably guess what to expect. Little light sherry, little bourbony, but mostly peat, right? Yeah, that's probably what's going on here. But there is more than just peat and smoke and everything. This is an Isla that I like because it shows the gentleness of Isla. And I will explain more of that after I pour them. As you can see, I have quite enjoyed this bottle. There's only a little bit left. And, well, I haven't had this in about 2-3 weeks, actually, because I wanted to save it for the review again. So I am actually going in this pretty blind. I can't remember I know what I thought about it. I liked it. That's why I drank the whole thing. But yeah, I have had whiskeys that I didn't like, but pretty much everything that comes out of Isla, I like, to be honest. So yeah, natural color. Yeah, it is bourbon-y, but it's a bit darker. It has a kind of a sherry type haze, deep. Yeah, it's not really amber. It's more golden amber. So yeah, on the nose. It is 40%, by the way. Yeah, you get that definite peat style. A little bit of smoke, peat, but mostly sea salt, sea spray, more like the Talisker type of note, but with more peat, more iodine. But yes, there are definitely sherry fruits in here. It is not just peat. It's more gentle. There are a really vast variety of different notes in here. And well, a lot of people think that this is one of the Lafroigs that's lacking all that stuff. And well, you see, when you first open the bottle, it's mostly, most of the time, not the best glass or best pour, whatever you want to call it. But is it when it gets down, the whiskey most of the time starts to get better, in my experience. And better, I mean, it reveals more of what it's capable of in terms of tastes and flavors. And that's the case with this. Yeah, the nose is not a peat bomb or anything, but it's definitely Isla. And well, if you want a subtle peat, this is one of those subtle whiskies. And yeah, on the first hint, there isn't much going on. But when you start to think about it and start to discover and make your way with this whiskey, it starts to open up to you. And that's something that I like. But yeah, it smells nice. It's an easy drinker, this. Like, I don't expect, I don't know, Ardbeg Oegdal complexity out of it, because, well, it's half the price, and it's way lower ABV, and it's, well, yeah. But it has that nice little peaty gummy bear something iodine flavor with it. I get a hint of, like, peated gummy bears. I don't know, if you would have made gummy bears of whiskey, you would get this now. Yes, it is light. It is maybe a little bit watery. But that's fine. If you just want to enjoy a whiskey, which is not harsh, not like when you get these cheap whiskeys, they are less refined. This is refined, yet easy to drink. That's something I don't come across really often. Maybe it's just a Lafroig thingy, but it has rich flavors. In the beginning, yeah, it's a bit meh, but then after a while it starts to develop, and the real surprise is in the finish. It is smooth, it's nice, it's gentle, but it brings that peatiness, it brings that little bit of a kick, of an intensity that you would like in an Isla, and you find that in this whiskey, and in terms of that, it doesn't disappoint, and it makes you want to go again. And then you smell it, and you smell that nice combination of gentle Isla notes and not that real hit peat slap in the face. But yeah, that might also be the case, you might say, because, well, the bottle is almost empty and all the peat has gone out. Well, I had that since the beginning. It was not like when I smell like a Voulin or other Lafroigs or like those really peaty art bags. It's like peat and more peat and peat and peat. And this is peat, but there is a lot more. You can notice that. And it's not that harsh of a peat note. And I like that. Yet it still has the complexity and real depth of a peated whiskey. It's a bit watery, yes. Peppery. White pepper. Mix them. mouth tingle a little bit. And, well, it's okay. A little bit of hay note, a little bit of bourbon note, a little bit of PX sherry. But then the whole thing comes alive when you swallow it. Palate starts to evolve. It goes down, then it evolves even more. The aftertaste is amazing. Like, the real party of this whiskey is in the aftertaste. And the nose, in my opinion. But, like, when you have it in your mouth and stuff, this is not a whiskey you take when you want to sit down and you want to have, like, a conversation with the whiskey, like, one-on-one, like, examine it properly. It's not that good of a whiskey, but you don't pay that high of a price either. But this is a whiskey you drink while watching a movie or having just a jolly old good time with your friends or anything, or when you're just doing something else. You just want a nice Islay that's not too distracting, that's not too harsh, and you just want a whiskey that's just damn good, in my opinion. And, well, this is it. And I will probably get another bottle of this because, well, it's cheap and I like it. And, yeah, sure, I like those really complex whiskeys, etc. But they take your mind off things when you're working or just... You just want to dram by the end of the day and you don't want to pour something really that expensive because, well, you know you are not going to take the time to appreciate that whiskey properly. And then this comes in because I love my peated whiskeys in the winter and, well, every single time of the year. And, well, this thing has gone down probably the quickest of all my bottles, I think. Is there anything that has gone down quicker? I am looking, but I don't think there is actually. Yeah, my Artbeg Oegedaal, but I saved that for a long time. I don't think there is. This is probably the bottle that has gone down the fastest. Because it's just so damn easy and just damn pleasant to drink. In my opinion, this is a really good one for people who start out their Islay journey. Just to get into things of what Islay whiskies can offer. This is a really good start. For people who like those really peaty and I don't know what they like, but this is not a whiskey for people who want the best of the best and stuff. This is a whiskey for people who are also looking at a budget. Like, I want an Islay, but that's not too much Islay with all the peat, etc. Because I like my bourbon notes, I like my little bit of sweet sherry notes. And, well, I just want a whiskey that doesn't require to sell my left liver. And, well, this is one of those whiskeys, and that's why I drank it a lot. Because, well, all of my Islays that are open at the moment are pretty expensive. And I go through them, but I don't want to go through them daily. Because, well, I drink whiskey probably on a daily basis. No, that doesn't mean I'm a drunk. Because in a properly poured glass of whiskey, the same amount of alcohol is present as in a beer. Or in a pour of wine. Those things are measured for a reason. I don't leave this whiskey too long in my mouth. Because then it loses its magic and it flattens out a little bit. Like I said, it's a little bit boring in the mid and the beginning palate. Because it's a little bit watery and there's not too much going on. And the finish is the main event. And that goes on for a while. And I haven't found that with, well, even more expensive whiskies. Like, it's still going, it's still developing. Still noticing peat, a little bit of honey, heather, grass. Yeah, I like it a lot. Yeah, these whiskies, Islay whiskies, are something, in my opinion. Like, I love sherries, I love bourbons, I love bourbon matured whiskies, I love pretty much every single whiskey that's out there. I haven't come across a whiskey that I really, really didn't like. Yeah, my Gold Label Reserve in the end. That was just so... It was awful. But this... Like, I even like Famous Grouse from time to time. And it's pretty good. But like this, it's cheap. And, well, you get this. And this is a awesome present whiskey. When I think about it, because it's the time of year, like, when somebody gives you this instead of, like, a normal whiskey, you know he actually done some research, etc. And don't get bogged down with all the people who say, oh, you should get the 10 or the triple woods or the blah, 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 blah. Well, those whiskeys are more intense. This is like, I want to give somebody like a more peated, like different style of whiskey, because he always drinks bourbons and sherries, etc. But then you give him this, and it's not like when you take the first sip, it's awful. They're like, I've given this to a couple friends who don't drink whiskey, and they liked it. And I also give it to a couple friends who only like Lowland whiskeys and sherry whiskeys, and they also liked it. I do need to say, though, it was more peaty in the beginning. But nowhere near, not even in the same postcode as Ardbeg 10 or Ardbeg Oegedaal, of like those really, really peated whiskies. Doesn't come close to it. But it has got that little bit of peat. And that's nice. That's nice. Little honey peaty with that Pedro Ximenez sherry sweetness in there. I just love it. And it's a really good whiskey, and well, it is gonna get finished probably this week, maybe even tonight if I look at it. Like, yeah, probably. But I don't know how many reviews I am going to do here. But yeah, this is just a damn good dram in my opinion. I had to finish it. Not going to waste here. Malt marks now. I'm not going to give it a 10 out of 10. I'm not. Because higher ABV and a little bit of a better mid palate would have been preferable. And my phone is going crazy over there. But I am going to give it a good mark that it deserves. In my opinion. And, well, if you want to experience with Isla whiskies, because you're not sure if you like them, Martijn. Hoe kun je Ardbeg 10 niet goed vinden, man? Wat is dat nou? Je vlecht nog op staan. Kom maar hier met dat ding. Ja. This is a whiskey that, in my opinion, deserves an 8 out of 10. Because, well, for the price, etc. I have seen this for 40 euros, etc. Don't get it then, but like around 30 euros. Yeah, it's just a damn good one. Like, same goes for Ardmore Legacy. Talking is hard. Ardmore Legacy is just also one of those whiskies that's a really, really pretty one if you give it time to explain itself to you. I'm going to get going. Thank you for watching. I hope you like this video. I am going to, try to make more reviews because I want to. But yeah, time, etc. It's just hard, but yeah, we will see what happens in the end. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you later. Goodbye.